Well, I'm not sure where to start. With Sue's challenge to fix the text. Or with the grace that can bring us. Change is going to come. Boy, don't we know that. But we need that. Sue, I can't fix this text. Not completely. I can fix it a little. This text starts with these words, and these words are important. Then the kingdom of God will look like this. And what does the story go on to talk about? Are we talking about angels on high, on the clouds above? Are we talking about something ethereal that we can't touch, that we can't grasp? Or are we talking about something as down to earth that people knew as a wedding? People know weddings. People can relate to weddings. Maybe not with this way in which the nasty girls aren't going to share with the other girls because they weren't prepared. But it's concrete. It's something that happens in people's lives. And in the first century, it was this big celebration. Even hungry people were fed for a whole week. It makes it very concrete. One of my favorite New Testament scholars is Amy Jill Levine. And she has, and others have, put together a resource called the Jewish Annotated New Testament. And she has a note in there about this particular text, and I think it's an important note. Oil, the oil for these lamps, is a metaphor. We can do metaphor, right? We don't need concrete, right? We're capable of that, right? Yes, Sally, we're capable of that. It's a metaphor for righteousness. Not self-righteousness, not the five bridesmaids who had the right amount of oil. No, not self-righteousness, righteousness. Being in right relationship with God. It's about good deeds. So if we can move out of the kind of literal approach to understanding this text and move back into what does it mean if the realm of God is here? In the Gospel of Matthew, just as it is true in the Gospel of Mark, in the Gospel of Luke, and to some extent also in the Gospel of John, the realm of God is this. It is here and now. And it requires that you and I participate. That you and I bring about love. That you and I bring about justice. That you and I bring about what is right and true. We don't leave it to someone else. We don't leave it to the bridesmaids who had enough oil or the bridesmaids who didn't have enough oil. We leave it to ourselves. Whatever it is we can do to help realize the realm of God. And maybe that's by singing and lifting up the spirits of the people around you. Maybe it's by being willing to every Sunday tell a children's message that it has even more meaning for the adults in the room. Maybe it's being one of the most amazing listeners God has put on this earth. Maybe it's being able and willing to sing amen at the drop. I'll bet we can do that. sitting me all the way around, this large sanctuary. I keep saying I'm going to wear my phone in here so I can get those steps, but I don't. Each of us has a lamp that we light. And sometimes, our lamps run out of oil, don't they? Sometimes. But we know that we're not alone. We're not the only one who has oil. Unlike our story where, for some reason, they don't want to share. I don't get it, but I don't have to. It's Matthew's story, not mine. And I'm happy to just say, okay. In faith community, in community chorus, we are never alone. There is always someone else. And we can come in dragging our tails sometimes, and someone next to us might even pick up that tail and carry it for us. Lift us. And sometimes we're the one doing the lifting, because we can share, right? Sometimes we get up in the morning and we know we can just go out there and do whatever it takes. That's good. And sometimes we can't. So if we can just get up and get out, get out from under those covers we pulled up over our head because we can't deal with all that's going on. All those covers back. Put a foot out of the bed. Maybe the other one will follow, let's hope. Otherwise you're gonna fall. You know how to do that. And you know, you don't even have to put on your clothes, you can just come in your jammies. I hope you come in something. It's too cold sometimes in here not to have something on. Other times it's hot and we'd be fine. But it would be awkward. Not all of us are used to that kind of openness. Some probably are. What have we learned in this past year? One of the things that Jim and I did last year at the end of the year when we were thinking about the gifts that we wanted to make to different organizations, we expanded the number of organizations that we were supporting because we realized that we needed to, and a whole lot of other people were as well. And we gave larger gifts than we had given before to some. One of the organizations that we hadn't actually supported in a long time was the Southern Poverty Law Center. They do amazing things. And they come up today for me, partly because we're talking about the reality of the world we live in, partly because we're talking about the what we as able-bodied people are able to do for people who are more challenged. It feels so much like it is the same thing. It boils down to showing up, standing up, and speaking up. Showing up means you need to be present. You need to be paying attention to what's going on. Whether it's someone who has a hard time getting through that door because it doesn't open, or it's someone who thought they were excluded because they're a different color, or they like a different kind of person than the pastor does. When those things are going on, we have to be paying attention so that everyone knows that we will open that door if it has been closed. We will make it easier to the extent that we can for people to be present and feel safe in this place. One of the resources that the Southern Poverty Law Center, really go to their website, seriously, Southern Poverty, just Google it and go to it. They have this bystander intervention guide, because there's been a whole lot of stuff going on where things that didn't used to happen as much are happening a lot, where people are being called out and yelled at and treated poorly, even more than it had been. So it's a bystander's guide. You know how it is when something's going on and you feel a little awkward and embarrassed and you're not really sure what to do, oh wait, they shouldn't be doing that, should they? You go, oh, what should I do, right? How should I respond to this? What can I do to make a difference? They actually have a guide. And it's a really sensible guide. It says, pay attention to what is going on. Pay attention to your own reactions. Pay attention to who you are, because some of us are more of a target than others of us. Know whether you're going to be a target, and know how to intervene. Sometimes the intervention is a very direct intervention. No, this is not all right, stop it. Yeah. If there's enough safety for you. Sometimes it's that you see someone being treated poorly and you ignore the person who's treating them poorly and you go up to the person who's being treated poorly and say, what time is it? Can you tell me what time it is? Hey, don't I know you from school? Weren't we in that class together? In other words, you go directly to the person who's being harassed and you ignore the harasser again only if it is a safe thing for you to do. Sometimes it happens so fast and you are so flustered, you go, oh no, now what? It's done. Well, you go over to the person who's been harassed. You say, I'm really sorry that happened. Is there anything I can do? Can I walk you to your next appointment? Can I stand here? Can I just sit here? Thank you. Sometimes it's engaging other people in what's going on. Can you help with what's going on? I'm feeling so alone. Come and help me with this. Always, it is pay attention to what is going on. Do not do something that could get the person who's being harassed into more difficulty. Do not get yourself into more difficulty, but do not just let it happen. There are copies of this in the back. I haven't made a lot of them. I didn't know if people would be interested in them, but I suggest that you pick up a copy, and if there are none left when you get there, Google Southern Poverty Law Center and take a look at it. Part of what we are doing in this new age is finding ways to show up, finding ways to stand up, finding ways to speak up. Because if a change is going to come, it has to start with us. And then we have to move it out. Each of us has oil in our lamp. Don't get tripped up by the words in the text. Each of us has oil. Each of us has gifts to share. Those gifts will make a difference. Those gifts will help.